Mr. Hale, before we start moving things about, can you tell Mr. Henderson, your police officer yesterday morning?
By the way, has anything been moved? Are things just as you left them yesterday?
It's just the same. When trouble was here last night, I thought I'd better send Frank out to make us a fire. No use getting the money with the big case on. I'm not told not to touch anything except for the stove. And you know Frank.
Somebody should have been left here yesterday.
Oh, yesterday. When I had to send Frank to Moore Center for that man that went crazy, I want you to know I had my hands full yesterday. I need to get back from Omaha by today, and I thought if I was going to hear everything here myself today.
Well, Mr. Hale, tell them what happened just when you came here yesterday morning.
Well, Harry and I had started town with a load of potatoes. As we came along the road from my place, I said, I'm going to see if I can't get John Wright to go in with me on a party telephone. I'd asked him that once before, but he just put me off, saying, well, we talked too much anyway, and all he asked was a little peace and quiet. Guess he knew about how much he talked himself, but I thought if I got there before his wife, though I said to Harry that I didn't know it was John Wright's wife, it would make much difference to him.
Let's talk about that later, Mr. Hale. I do want to talk about that. Well, tell now just what happened when you got to the house.
Well, I didn't hear or see anything, so I came up and I knocked on the door. Still, it was all quiet. I knew they must be up. It was past 8, so I knocked again. I thought I heard someone say come in. I wasn't sure. I'm still not sure, but I opened the door, that door, and there, that rocker, sat Mrs. Wright.
What was she doing?
Well, she had her apron in her hands. She was rocking back and forth and kind of leaping at it.
And how did she look?
Well, she looked queer.
How do you mean queer?
Like, she didn't know what she was going to do next. Kind of done up.
And how did she seem to feel about your coming?
Why, I don't think she minded one way or other. I said, how do this, right? It's cold out, ain't it? She just said, is it? Went on bleating at her apron. Well, I was surprised she didn't ask me to come up or to sit down, but sat there rocking back and forth. So I said, I came to see John. At that, she just laughed. I guess you could call it a laugh. I thought of Harry and the team outside, so I said a little sharp, can I see John? No, she said, kind of double like. Well, ain't he home? I said. Yes, she said, he's home. Well then, why can't I see him? Because he's dead, she said, unconcerned. Dead? Yes. Just went on pleading at her anger. Well, why? Where is he? I asked her. She just pointed upstairs like that. I walked from there to here and stopped and asked her, well, why? Well, what did he die of? He died of a rope around his neck, she said. I went out and got Harry. I thought I might need help. And so we got upstairs. There he was lying.
I think I'd rather you go into that upstairs where you can point everything all out. Just go on now with the rest of your story.
Well, my first thought was to get that rope off his neck. It looked... But Harry goes up to him and he says, no, he's dead all right. We'd better not touch him. So we went back downstairs, and she was still just sitting that same way. Has anybody been notified? I asked. No, she said. Who did this, Mrs. Wright? Said Harry. He said it real business-like. I don't know, she said. You don't know? He asked her. No, she said. Wasn't you sleeping in the bed with him? Well, yes, but I was on the inside. Somebody slipped a rope around his neck and you didn't wake up, he asked her. I didn't wake up, she said after. Well, we must have looked as if we didn't see how that could be, for after a moment, she said, I sleep sound. Harry was going to ask her more questions, but I told him we ought to let her tell her story first to the coroner or to the sheriff, so Harry went as fast as he could to River Place, where there's a telephone.
And what did Miss Wright do when she knew you'd gone for the coroner?
Well, she moved from that chair to this one over here, sat there with her hands held together, looking down. I got a feeling I ought to make some conversation, so I said, I came to see if John would put in the telephone. At that, she laughed, stopped, looked, scared. I don't know, maybe it wasn't scared, I wouldn't like to say it was. Well, soon Harry got back, then Dr. Lloyd, and you, Mr. Peters, and I suppose that's about all I know that you don't.
I suppose we'll go upstairs first, and then out to the barn out there. You're sure there wasn't anything important here? Nothing that could point to any motive?
Nothing here for kitchen things.
Here's a nice mess.
Oh, her fruit, it did freeze. She worried about that when it turned so cold. She said the fire would go out and her jars would break.
Well, can you feed the woman? Hail from murder, you worried about the preserves.
I guess before we're through here, she may have something more serious than preserves to worry about.
Well, women are used to worrying over trifles.
And yet, for all their worries, what would we do without the ladies? Dirty towels. No wonder my housekeeper, would you say, ladies?
There's a great deal of work to be done on a farm.
To be sure. And yet, I know there are some Dixon County farmhouses which do not have such roller towels.
Those towels get dirty awful quick. Men's hands aren't always as clean as they might be.
Loyal to your sons, I see. But you and Mrs. Wright were neighbors. I suppose you were friends, too.
I've not seen much of her of late years. I've not been in this house. It's more than a year.
And why was that? You didn't like her.
I liked her all well enough. Farmers' wives have their hands full, Mr. Henderson. And then...
Yes?
It never seemed a very cheerful place.
No, it's not cheerful. I shouldn't say she had the homemaking instinct.
Well, I don't know as Wright had either.
You mean they didn't get on very well?
No, I don't mean anything. But I don't think a place be any cheerfuler for John Wright's being in it.
I'd like to talk about that a little later, Mr. Hill. I want to get the lay of things upstairs.
I suppose anything Mrs. Peterson doesn't feel right, she wasn't taking some clothes for her and some other things. We left in such a hurry yesterday.
Yes, but I'd like to see what you take, Mr. Peterson. Keep an eye out for anything that may be of use to us.
Yes, Mr. Henderson. Around and criticizing.
Of course, it's no more than their duty.
Well, duty's all right. But I guess that deputy sheriff that came out to make the fire might have got a little of this on. Wish I'd thought of that sooner. Seems mean to talk about her for not having things slicked up when she had to come away in such a hurry.
She had what said?
She was going to put this in there. It's a shame about her fruit. I wonder if it's all gone. I think there's some here that's all right, Mrs. Peters. Yes, here. This is cherries, too. I declare I believe that's the only one. She'll be awful upset after all her hard work and the hot weather. I remember the afternoon I put up my cherries last summer.
Well, I must get those things from the farm closet. You coming with me, Mrs. Hale? You can help me carry them. My, it's cold in there.
Right, was closed. I think maybe that's why she kept so much to herself. She didn't even belong to the ladies, eh? But then, I suppose she felt she couldn't do her part, and you don't enjoy things when you feel shabby. She used to wear pretty clothes and be lively when she was Minnie Foster, one of the town girls singing in the choir, but that, oh, that was 30 years ago. This all you want to take in?
She said she wanted an apron. A funny thing a lot, for goodness knows there isn't much in jail to get dirty. But I suppose just to make it feel more natural. car in this cupboard. Yes. Here. And I'm not shot. I always have to find the door. Yes, here it is.
Mrs. Peters.
Yes, Mrs. Hale?
Do you think she did it?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, I don't think she did. Asking for an apron and a little shawl, worrying about her fruit.
Mr. Peters says it looks bad for her. Mr. Henderson is awful sarcastic in his speech, and he'll make fun of her saying she didn't wake up.
Well, I guess John Wright didn't wake up when they was slipping that rope under his neck.
No, it's strange. It must have been done awful crafty and stale. They say it was such a funny way to kill a man, rigging it all up like that.
That's just what Mr. Hale says. There was a gun in the house. He says that's what he can't understand.
Mr. Henderson said coming out that what he had for the case was a motive. Something to show anger, sudden feeling.
Well, I don't see any signs of anger around here. It's white to here. Wonder how they're finding things upstairs. I hope she had it a little more red up there. You know, it seems kind of sneaking. Locking her up in town and then coming out here and trying to get her own house to turn against her.
Mrs. Hale, the law is the law.
I suppose it is. Better loosen up your things, Mrs. Peters. You won't feel them when you go out.
Oh, she was piecing a quilt.
It's log cabin pattern. Pretty, isn't it? I wonder if she was going to quilt it or just knot it.
They're wondering if she's going to quilt it or just knot it.
Well, Frank's didn't do much upstairs, did it? Let's go out to the barn and get back there now.
I don't see if there's anything so strange, us taking up our time with little things while we're waiting for them to get the evidence. I don't see as it's anything to laugh about.
Of course, they've got all important things on their minds.
Mrs. Peters, look at this. Here, this is the one she was working on, and look at the sewing. All the rest has been so nice and even, and look at this. It's all over the place. Why, it looks as if she didn't know what she was about.
Oh, what are you doing, Mrs. Hale?
Just pulling out a stitch or two that's not sewed very good. Bad sewing's always made me fidgety.
I don't think we ought to touch things.
I'll just finish up this end. Mrs. Peters.
Yes, Mrs. Hale.
What do you suppose she was so nervous about?
Oh, I don't know if she was nervous. I sometimes feel awful clear when I'm just tired. Well, I better get these things wrapped up. They may be through sooner than we think. I wonder if I can, where I can find a piece of paper, some string.
In that cupboard, maybe.
Well, here's a bird cage. Did she have a bird, Mrs. Hale?
Why, I don't know whether she did or not. I've not been here for so long. There was a man around last year selling canaries cheap. Maybe she took one. I don't know what she did. She used to sing real pretty herself.
It seems funny to think of a bird in here, though. I wonder what happened to it.
I suppose maybe the cat got it.
Oh, no. She didn't have a cat. She's got that feeling some people have about them, being afraid. Why, my cat got in her room the other day, and she got awful upset and asked me to take him out.
My sister Bessie was like that. Queer, ain't it?
Well, Mrs. Hale, look at this door. One used to pull the pot.
It looks as if someone must have been rough with it.
Why, yes.
I wish if they're going to find any evidence, they'd be about it. I don't like this place.
Oh, but I'm awful glad it came for you, Mrs. Hale. It would be awful lonesome for me if I were to sit here alone.
It would be, wouldn't it? But I tell you what I do wish, Mrs. Peters. wish I'd come here sometimes when she was here. I wish I had.
Well, of course, we're all busy. Your house and your children.
I could have come. I stayed away because it weren't cheerful. And that's why I ought to have come. I never liked this place. Maybe because it's down in a hollow and you don't see the road. I don't know what it is, but it's a lonesome place and always was. I wish I'd come to see Minnie Foster sometimes. I can see now.
Not to reproach yourself, Mrs. Hale. Sometimes we just don't see how it is with other folk until something comes up.
Not having children makes less work, but it makes a quiet house and right out to work all day and no company when he did come in. Did you know John Wright, Mrs. Peters?
Not to know him, but I've seen him in town. They say he was a good man.
Yes, good. He didn't drink and kept his word as well as most, I guess. He paid his debts. But he was a hard man, Mrs. Peters. Just to pass the time of day with him, like a raw wind that gets to the bone. I should think she would have wanted a bird. But what do you suppose went with it?
I don't know. Must have got sick and died.
You weren't raised around here, were you? You didn't know her.
Not till they brought her yesterday.
She, come to think of it, she was kind of like a bird herself. Real sweet and pretty, but kind of timid and fluttery. How she did change. Tell you what, Mrs. Peters, why don't you take the quilting with you? It might take up her mind.
Well, I think that's a real nice idea, Mrs. Hale. Now, just what would I take? I wonder if the patches are in here. And things.
Here's some red. I expect this has got some things in it. What a pretty box. Looks like something somebody would give you. Maybe her scissors aren't here. Why, there's something wrapped up in this piece of silk.
Why, that's not her scissors.
Oh, Mrs. Peters, it's...
It's the bird!
But Mrs. Peters, look! Look at it, look at its neck, it's all... Other side, too.
Somebody wrung its neck.
Well, have you figured out what she was going to? Quilt it or not it?
We think she was going to not it.
That's interesting, George. Has the bird flown?
We think the cat got it.
Is there a cat?
Well, not now. They're superstitious, you know. They leave.
No sign of anyone having come in from outside. Their own room. Now, let's go back upstairs and go over piece by piece. We've had to do so.
She liked the bird. She was going to bury it in that pretty box.
When I was a girl, my kitten, some boys took a hatchet before my eyes, before I could get there. The helmet hadn't held me back, but it hurt them.
I wonder how it would seem, never to have any children around. No, Wright wouldn't have liked the bird, a thing that sang. She used to sing. He killed that too.
We don't know who killed the bird.
I knew John Wright.
And all the things was done in this house that night, Mrs. Hale. Killed a man on his lips, slipping a rope around his neck that choked the life out of him.
His neck. Choked the life out of him.
We don't know who killed him. We don't know.
If there had been years and years of nothing and then a bird to sing to you, it would be awful. Still, after the bird was still.
I know what stillness is. When we homesteaded back in Dakota, after my first baby died, and me with no other than...
How soon do you suppose they'll be through looking for the evidence?
I know what stillness is, but love has got to punish crime, Mrs. Hale.
I wish you'd seen Minnie Foster when she wore a white dress with blue ribbons and stood up there in the choir and sang. Oh, I wish I'd come here once in a while. That was a crime. That was a crime. Who's going to punish that?
We mustn't take on.
I might have known she needed help. I know how things can be for women. I tell you, it's queer, Mrs. Peters. We live together and we live far apart. We all go through the same things. It's just a different kind of the same thing. If I was you, I wouldn't tell her her fruit was gone. Tell her it ain't. Tell her it's all right. Take this to prove it to her. She may never know whether it was broke or not.
Mom, good thing made good appearance. Getting all stirred up over such a thing as the dead canary. As if that could have anything to do with the. Oh, what if they just laugh?
Maybe they would. Maybe they would.
No, Pierce. It's all perfectly clear, except for a reason for doing it. But, you know, juries when it comes to women. If only there was something. Something to show. Something we could make a story about. Something that would connect with this strange way of doing it.
Well, I got the team around. It's pretty cold out there.
I'm gonna stay here a while by myself. You can send Frank out for me, can't you? I want to go over everything. I'm not satisfied that we can't do better.
Do you want to see what Mrs. Peters has taken in?
I don't suppose very dangerous things the ladies have picked out. No, Mrs. Peters doesn't need supervision. For that matter, the sheriff's wife is married to the law. Ever think of it that way, Mrs. Peters?
Not just that way.
Married to the law. I'll come in here a minute, George. We'll take a look at these windows.
Windows.
We'll be right on, Mr. Hale.
What is it you call it, ladies?
We call it knotted.